Right, so currently we have our bird body. I want to be able to make our two wings, one for each side, and I want to be able to work with the comb and the wattle a little bit. In fact, one first thing I might want to do is actually want to come in and flatten out the back of this tail a little bit. That's one thing I forgot to do in the last section. So I'm going to grab those, scale them down, rotate just a little bit, scale, move this out, and scale in these two sort of side pieces. That's going to give me a little bit more of a fluid tail. There we go. I think that's working a little bit better. Well, now it's time for the wings. And again, I'm going to start off with NURBS spheres for these. I created a sphere from my surfaces shelf, and I hit 3 to make that sphere smooth. I'm going to rotate this into place. I'm actually going to rotate it negative 180 degrees, and then rotate it forward a little bit with the yellow rotation circle. I will hit R and scale this flat, and I'm going to scale it a little bit elongated along its main axis. And if you see what I'm actually putting together here, I'm looking at creating a bit of a wing for the side of the bird. R for the scale tool, scale this down a little bit. E for the rotate tool. W for the move tool. And E to rotate. And I'm just roughly trying to put this in place and give it a good size that somewhat closely matches what we see here. Now I do probably want to curve this to the form, so I'm just going to take my vertices and start to manually move them so they round out to the body a little bit more. I also want to try and taper it a little bit towards the back end. You can see I'm doing that by choosing which vertices to push and pull here, making sure that my form doesn't look like it's intersecting too much. Don't forget to look underneath your model or top down on your model. They can be very valuable views to actually seeing your proportions. So you'll notice that I constantly keep rotating around my form just to keep checking that. Let's exaggerate that wing out just a little bit. Size. And for a sphere, I think we've got a pretty well-defined little wing shape, very simply by just pushing and pulling that around. It's close enough for my purposes. Let's actually, you know what, let's scale this up just a little bit more. There we go. Now I'm liking it. Well, that's one wing. Let's get the other. So I'm going to duplicate this over to the other side. To do that, I'm going to choose Modify, Freeze Transformations, so that all of my channels in the channel box go back to 0 and 1. And then I'm going to choose Modify, Reset Transformations. After it's already frozen in place, I'll reset it to send the pivot point back to the origin. Then by going to Edit, Duplicate Special, I'm going to go to the Options box, I'll be able to send over a duplicate of this wing to the other side. I'm done with the wing right now, so I don't need an instance. I don't need that active copy. So I'll reset this to copy, a regular geometry type, and hit duplicate special. So my scale set to -1 on the x-axis. And I've got two wings. Let's go to Window, Hypergraph Hierarchy. I've got NURBS Sphere 3 and NURBS Sphere 4. Well, I don't really want those named the way they are. I'll rename NURBS Sphere 3 L wing for left wing. And NURBS Sphere 4, I'll rename R wing. And I'll just select both of these and using my middle mouse button, drag them right onto the words chicken toy. Giving me a fully set up group here. I've got chicken toy now with all of my parts brought together. So what we've got to do next, the last sort of NURBS operations we're going to deal with, is I want to make the comb along the top and the little wattle along the bottom. And I'm also going to rough these in with NURBS spheres. I create a new NURBS sphere and hit 3 to make it smooth. Again, I want the seam to be along the back side just so it remains symmetrical. So I'll rotate it a little bit to see which axis I need to rotate it on. And in the channel box, since the only values other than 0 and 1 here are in the y-axis for rotation, well, then I know 90 degrees does it correctly in the y. What I can do now is I'll grab R for the scale tool, and I'll flatten this out. And then I'll take my red box and elongate it just a little bit. And my center box to uniformly scale it and just pull it down. I hit W for the move tool, take my green arrow and pull it up, my blue arrow and pull it forward, and now I've got kind of like a mohawk on this chicken. Well, looking at my form, what I need to do here is actually taper the front edge down a little bit while leaving the back edge a little bit more vertical. So I'm going to do this by, again, scaling in my form a little bit. And I'm actually going to work in the side view, which is going to allow me to manipulate this a little bit more freely. So I'll hit spacebar to jump to my four-panel view. And when my cursor is over the side view, I'll hit spacebar again. Now I can just drag a selection over what I see, and it should allow me to very easily start to manipulate this form. I can be pretty rough with a lot of this. Again, we're not looking for exact at this point. I just hit 4 to enter wireframe to help me see this a bit better. And I'll move these up a little bit here to help my curvature. Maybe I create a little peak that kind of comes up and down. To me, that profile looks somewhat similar to what I see in my reference and what I'm basing this on. Except actually, you know what, I'm going to try and take this point, move it down a little bit more. See if we can get that to become a little bit more diagonal there. And there we go. I think that's a pretty successful little comb. So my next step is to do the same thing with a wattle. And again, one more NURBS sphere. I'll hit 3 to make it round. I'll rotate this exactly 90 degrees in the y-axis. Choose R for the scale tool and flatten it out. Scale it down uniformly along the center axis. And then with the move tool, I'm going to move it up into position just underneath the chin. I'll hit spacebar and again go preview this in my side view. And now I can move these points around just like before. And again, these intersecting as they are right now, it isn't optimal with more advanced modeling, but it's something that I think really allows you to start to visualize the form at this introductory level. And so there we go. I think this is working pretty nicely. We'll compare the two. Let's go ahead into my hypergraph. Rename the two parts. The first one I'll call comb. The second one I'll call wattle. And I'll drag both of these into the toy group. Next video, we'll start building the legs.